If you're looking to work in any kind of MNC, then you should really have the knowledge of this technology called as cloud native. This is definitely the modern way to develop software. The new approach to developing software is cloud native. It can help you to build and run software applications that can exploit flexibility, scalability, and resilience. When companies build and operate applications using a cloud native architecture, they bring new ideas to market faster, which helps them in responding sooner to customer demands. While public cloud has put its mark on every industry, cloud native development is appropriate for both public and private clouds. It's about how applications are created and deployed, not where. The cloud native approach to building and running software was pioneered by a group of companies commonly referred as born in the cloud, such as streaming giants like Netflix and Spotify, or you can call a ride hailing company as a Uber, and accommodation booking platform like Airbnb. The cloud native computing foundation, CNCF, you should remember this. This defines the cloud native a little more narrowly, focusing on application content where applications are broken down into microservices and packages in lightweight containers to be deployed across a variety of servers. The CNCF was formed in 2015 in response to the abundance of organizations and services adopting cloud native system. Now, this project was again created by Linux Foundation and an open source software foundation that promotes the adoption of cloud native technology. Microsoft, Oracle, and Intel are some of the platinum members of CNCF. Cloud native development incorporates the concept of DevOps, continuous delivery, microservices, and containers. Now, DevOps collaborates between software and developers and IT operations to deliver the high quality software that solves the customer challenges on a production level. Continuous delivery is moving incremental software changes into the production constantly through the automation. Now, microservices is an architectural approach to developing an application as a collection of small services. Each service implements business capabilities, runs in its process, and communicates via HTTP APIs or messaging. Now, these microservices enables frequent updates to live application without impacting customers. This is really a wonderful feature out there. Now, these containers offers both efficiency and speed compared with standard virtual machines. Using operating systems level virtualization, a single OS is instance that is dynamically divided among one or more isolated containers, each with a unique writable file system and resource quota. Now, cloud native offers a transformative way to reduce risk in enterprise based on three basic principles. Now, the first principle could be you can repair the vulnerable software as soon as updates are available. The second one could be you can frequently replace servers and applications from a known good state, and you can also rotate user credentials often. Now, you must be thinking that why do cloud native applications matter the most? Because it has gained a competitive advantage. You can also achieve greater flexibility. You can align operations with business needs. And definitely, if you are in IT and if you talk about DevOps, then automation is really important out there. In upcoming videos, we are also going to talk about the basic pillars of cloud native. For example, you should really know that what exactly are the Kubernetes, how you can work with Docker and different technologies like this. But that's it for this video. I'll see you again tomorrow with another video. And don't forget to subscribe this channel for more tech related videos.